त्वं भक्ति योग परिभावित हित सरोज आससे सुतेक्षित पतनुनाथ पुंसं यद यद धिया तो उर्गाय विभावयति तत्तद वपुपनयसे सदनु गृहाय। सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड, इफ आवर डिजायर, वी हैव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ डिजायर, इफ यू कैन हार्मोनाइज आवर डिजायर विद द डिजायर्स ऑफ प्रभु ऑफ भगवान सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, देन वी कैन बिकम हैप्पी। इफ यू कैन हार्मोनाइज आवर हार्ट विद गुरुदेव, if we can harmonize our heart with Supreme Lord, then and only then we become happy. Otherwise, no question of any happiness, actual happiness. Actually, point is that, first the slok with which I started with, here actually, it is written, the Supreme Lord can manifest Himself in front of His devotee according to His heart, according to His heart and desire. Bhagavan Supreme Lord can manifest Himself, like today is the appearance day of Varaha Bhagavan, Varaha Dadasi. So, sometime Supreme Lord can come in front of Prahlad Maharaj in the form of Nishimhadev, sometime as Varahadev, sometime Ramchandra, sometime Kurmadev. This is the rules actually. But one thing very important, Tvang Bhakti Yoga Paribhavita Hit Saruj Asase Sutekshita Patana Nunata Pungsam. Nonu means nishchitameva, 100%, be know it for sure that Supreme Lord, how you can understand that Supreme Lord giving you full kripa. First of all, sutekshita patho, first you will have to hear harikatha from an elevated devotee. Then that speech, Harikatha, can come into your heart. Shrutekshita patho. First you will have to hear, then you can see. In material world, first we can see, then we can pass judgment, material world. This is the system. We can see, we can pass judgment, we can understand that. But in this, spiritual line here, in Sauta Pantha, is a system, first you will have to hear, then that speech can enter into your heart, like Brahma, when Brahma was initiated, first he hear. Then that sound vibration coming into heart and giving some reaction, then Brahma can feel everything. That was the system, when Brahma was first initiated. So, first you will have to hear sutekshita pato. Suto matlab means first you will have to hear. Ikshan means in Sanskrit to see. You can see. Through speech, you can see everything. Inside your heart, you can see everything. This is the system. Yad yad dhyat urugaya vibhavayati tat tat brapo pranayase sadanu gruhayo. Supreme Lord is very merciful. He can manifest Himself in front of His devotee according to His desire. Like in front of Tulsidas, though Bhagavan Sri Krishna came in front of Tulsidas in Vrindavan, still Tulsidas requesting him, I like to see my Ishtadev. Then Bhagavan Sri Krishna, in the form of Ramji, in front of Tulsidas ji came. This is the system. Today is the appearance day of Varahadev. Today is the appearance day of Varahadev actually. But you see here Kulodev, one Kulodev there. There one Brahman was there. used to worship Varahadeva all day and night. In Parikrama books you can find. Ultimately, that Brahman, that pure devotee was very lucky. In front of you, in front of him, Varahadeva appeared. It is written. So, actually today is the appearance day of Varahadeva, Varahadeva Dadasi. And when Varahadeva came here, manifest himself. That is the main question. I like to discuss this point and why he came. This is the point. First of all, I like to discuss some basic point. Like, you know, Kashyap Rishi. From Kashyap Rishi, we can get this all population. A demon and demigods, they all came from Kashyap Rishi. And Kashyap Rishi actually Diti and Aditi, two wives. Diti and Aditi. Aditi mother, she is the mother of all demigods. Diti, she is the mother of all demons. He is the system. But actually, when Vidurji Maharaj traveling after, you know, some problem there in Hastinapur, Vidurji Maharaj went away from that Hastinapur and started traveling into different pilgrimage. In the meantime, he met with Uddhavji Maharaj. He have had some discussion, nice discussion, Harikatha. Uddhav Maharaj is expressing some deep feeling, everything. But after that, Uddhavji Maharaj asking him, Vidurji Maharaj, you can go at the bank of Ganga. There Maitreya Muni waiting for you to give you transcendental knowledge. He is there. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, he is going to give you, he is waiting for you. Actually, Maitreya Muni, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna disappeared from this material world, then Maitreya Muni was there with Uddhav. Final, last advice, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of Uddhav and Maitreya Muni. So Maitreya Muni was there. So Bhagavan Sri Krishna advised him that you can meet with Vidur someday in near future. You can speak all tattva what I am speaking now. So this way you see, Maitreya Muni waiting at the bank of Ganga and he is waiting for Vidur. And this way Vidurji Maharaj somehow, the advice of Uddhavji Maharaj, is meeting Maitreya Muni and he paid dandavat. Actually, Vidurji Maharaj is not ordinary personality. He is Sakshat Jamraj, Mahajan. 12 Maharaj, you know, Dadas Mahajan is one of them, knowing everything. But this is a Leela. They are manifesting this kind of Leela to teach us, give us a lesson, you see, this way. So, actually, Vidurji Maharaj meeting Maitreya Muni. Now, Maitreya Muni is speaking all about this Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. And now he is discussing about this point, I mean, from Kashyap Muni, Diti, Aditi. From Aditi, all demigods came. And Kashyap Muni doing bhajan. Hari Bhajan, very. And actually, point is that Diti become jealous because all demigods, Aditi, Maya, is actually so many songs and everything. I mean, demigods came, but he has no children, nothing. So she is very unhappy. So one day, actually, when Kashyap Muni in the evening time going to do his final sacrifice, I mean, you know, Then actually, Diti came in front of husband, Swami, and requesting him for a children, baby. So Kashyap Muni is saying, okay, it's very right, I can fulfill your desire, but this time is very, evening time is not auspicious time actually. Evening time actually Shankar Bhagavan, Mahadev with ghost there, traveling here and there. This time is not good actually, you will have to wait for that. But Diti, she was very unrest. So anyhow, Kashyap Muni now praying to Supreme Lord, what to do? This is the situation. I like to stop occurring this kind of unusual thing, but maybe it is approved by you. So she is putting pressure on me. So that time, Kashyap Muni praying to Supreme Lord, please excuse me, this is the situation, what to do? Then Kashyap Muni wanted to fulfill the desire of wife, Diti. But after taking bath in Nadi, in river, Kashyap Muni was chanting Gayatri Mantra to purify. He is pure always, but still taking bath with full cloth and praying Gayatri Mantra to purify himself, very silently. But Diti became very shy now, in front of husband and paying dandavat and saying, excuse me, I have done wrong, but what to do? And then she could get some realization, actually, I have done some wrong thing, please excuse me, I fear some problem can be there. Then Kashyap Muni is speaking, yes, of course, some problem going to happen. What problem? Your son become very big demon. He's going to put operation to all creature, become very fearful. So what to do now? Then she requesting him, what to do, I don't know. You please bless me so that I can. But no, 100% you are going to get your son become demon, very big problem. He is going to put all creation disturbed by him. So after that, Kashyap Muni is speaking, well, by your grandson, in their destiny and race, one grandson you can get. He is going to purify the whole world. His name is Prahlad Maharaj. Hiranyakasipu and Hiranyaksha. Then gradually, there's a Diti mother, she going to give birth to two twin boys. One is Hiranyakasipu, Hiranyaksha. Hiranyakasipu is elder. Hiranyaksha junior. Is very great love, strong love for younger brother. So this way you see, day by day actually they are growing up and they are making problem for whole creation, they are disturbing everybody. Sometime Hiranyaksha with club going to Varundev, I like to fight with you. I heard you are very powerful. This way, Varundev say, well, you like to fight with me, but better you will have to wait. You have to fight with Vishnu, is most powerful. You can get enjoyment because you are a big fighter. Those who are fighter, they always like to get a fitting, a matching personality. So you will have to wait. I am not matching for you. You have to wait for that. So this way, where I can get? This way, he is searching Vishnu. Now, another point in Bhagavad discourse, usually I discuss this point. When Varahadev came, actually Shet Varaha and Shyam Varaha, two kinds of Varaha, we get information that two kinds of Varaha. One is Shet Varaha, one is Krishna Varaha. So, which Varaha, when came, this is a big problem. Because Maitreya Muni, when discussing this point, he is discussing two points at a time. He is not clarifying this point. He is not clarifying this point. He is saying Varahadev appear and then Varahadev have had a fight with Hiranyaksha, kill him. This way he delivered this earth, Prithivi Devi, this way. Now those who are making commentary, Vishwanath Chakravartivad, they are making nice judgment. How is that possible that Varahadev fighting with, Hiranyaksha, and how is that possible? Because two Varaha, we get information, two Varaha. One is Shet Varaha. In Shet Varaha Kalpo, that is Svayambhuva Manyanta, that time, that Adi Varaha, Shet Varaha appeared. When actually Manu, Vishwanath Chakravarti was giving argument. Manu, Manuputra, Priyabrata and Uttanapad. And in Uttanapad, after that Dhruva, and in that destiny, gradually we get, Pracheta. And from Pracheta we get Daksha, Pracheta's Daksha. And from Daksha we get Ditya Aditi, this kind of, expansion. So how is that possible? Because Adi Varaha, Shet Varaha, that time, there was no Aditi, Diti, then how we can understand that Hiranyakasipu came and have a, that time no possible? Shet Varaha is before, Svayambhuva Manantar, Shet Varaha Kalpa, that time actually in Svayambhuva Manantar, then that Shet Varaha appeared. How? When Bhagavan, Sri Krishna giving instruction to Brahma for creation, Brahma got power, Chatisloki Bhagavatam, And Bhagavan Sri Krishna blessing Brahma, Brahma crying, you giving me such a seva, so I can feel disturbance all the time. I cannot concentrate my mind. So you are giving, creation means problem all the time. Creation, different kind of creation, different kind of problem. So I'll have to concentrate. How I can concentrate? Bhagavan Sri Krishna blessing him. No problem. You can feel no problem. If you carry out my order, then there is no problem. No disturbance you can feel. So I bless you, no problem. You go on, proceed. Then Brahma, first creation of Manu and Satarupa. Manu and Satarupa. First creation, Manu and Satarupa. Before that, actually, previously, those Chatusan Adi, from Brahma came. But they are not ready to expand creation. They are less interested. Brahma giving instruction, my son, you will have to carry out my order because I got this kind of order from Supreme Lord. So also you will have to carry out my order so that you can create Srishti, creation can go on and on. Chatusan said, no, we cannot do. Why? Why you cannot carry out my? No, we feel disturbed. We like to do bhajan. Bhajan? You cannot carry out my order? No, we cannot do. And Brahma become very angry. So angry, Brahma cannot check his angry attitude. Brahma trying to control, get control over his angry attitude, but we cannot control. So then from Kurchades, in Sanskrit it is Kurchades, in between this eyebrow, 2 points here. Then Rudra coming out, taking birth. Rudra crying. Hey, why you are crying? Stop crying. I can give you place and I can give you all facility. Then by the blessing of Brahma, Rudra, Ekadas Rudra, 11 Rudra, 11 Rudras. How 11 Rudra? How they are the demigods of, you know, false ego, abhiman, angry attitude, abhiman. So this way, you see, 11 Rudra means 5 karmendriya, and 5 ganendriya, five karmendriya, five ganendriya. For your activities, 5 karmendriya, 5 ganendriya, indriya. 5, 5, 10. And mind is another kind of indriya, which is strongest of all indriya. Mind, you cannot see mind, but mind is strongest of all. If mind is not attached, is mind going to do non-cooperation, no indriya can do any activities. So mind is the strongest of all. So this way, 5 karmendriya, 5 ganendriya, and mind, this more 11. So Rudra can act in this 11 and indriya, can show his activities, power. This way, actually, after that, I am speaking all after. When all creation freely failure, then Brahma, from Brahma, actually Satarupa and Manu came. 2 parts. After that, Satarupa and Manu started doing bhajan at the bank of Gomati Ganga, which is called actually Naimisharana. Naimisharana, at the bank of Gomati Ganga, they started doing bhajan, very strong bhajan. After that, Brahma became very satisfied. Brahma saying, I am very happy by your study and penances. What do you want? Oh, Father, we like to carry out your order. We like to carry out. Okay. Then go on doing. I bless you. But where to do? There's no place where to do creation. Where to? The creation is not possible because earth already inside water. Then, actually, there, Brahma bless him. Okay, so all problem can be solved. No problem. Then after that, he is thinking, in the meantime, from nozzle hole, Varaha Deva, very small particle coming. With sneezing. From him, Varaha Deva coming. And after the in front of Manu, you see, saying, I mean, Brahma, actually from Brahma. Yeah. From Brahma, when thinking, when Manu speaking, you give place where to do. Brahma then thinking how to do. In the meantime, then Varahadev came out in front of Brahma. It takes big form, gradually going in space. Then after that, making big sound. Then Brahma become very happy. I don't know, understand who is he? Then he could understand, okay, Varahadev. Then Varahadev gradually, you see, to help them for the occasion, going into water and searching earth. And after that, with 2 teeth, taking earth and placing in proper place and vanish. In Sed Varaha Kalpa, the first Mananta, this kind of Varahavata, this way happened. I mean, Varahadev appear and deliver the earth from water, and after that, vanish, gone. Sed Varaha. Then point is that Sed Varaha actually deliver. Then after that, creation was possible. Go on. Otherwise, no possible. And another Varaha, that is Sam Varaha, it was only possible in Chakshushmanantar from Prachetas Daksha. Actually, Daksha committed apradh unto the lotus feet of Shankar Bhagavan. Son in law. Those who are material people, they have their bloody conception. I would say they have their bloody conception. He is my son-in-law, he is my father, he is my mother. Why this conception? But those who are having fine darshan, they never think that way. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur never seek that Bimala Krishna is my son. Never speak. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur never think he is my father. This way. This is actually this way, actually point is that in Chakshus Manantar, another Brahma. How? Actually, then when Daksha committed apraat, he was in powerful position. That post was given by Brahma. All praja, the people, they are adhyaksha, principal. So naturally he is popped up. He is always full of vanity. Then after that, he committed opera unto the lotus feet of Shankar Bhagavan, speaking all rubbish against Shankar Bhagavan. And Shankar Bhagavan, then what to do? He don't know what to do. And gone. After that, things have this way, actually problem happened. Sati Bhagavan, Sati, I mean, daughter of Daksha, first Daksha, not Pachetas Daksha, first. Then, Sati Devi, the daughter of Daksha, naturally, Shankar Bhagavan marry. So this way, actually, Sati Devi wanted to go to a big utsav function, Jagya. Shankar Bhagavan speaking, you cannot go there because you cannot give honor there. Because your father always have an angry attitude against me. He is always hating me. I don't know why. I have done nothing wrong, but still, he is always against me. So anyway, if you go there, well, we can go. It's my father house. Well, you can go. Father house to Gurudev, to friend, and father house need not taking any permission. Shankar Bhagavan speaking, he's not inviting me. Well, we can go, because father's house, Gurudev, to friends, without any permission, anybody can go. This is the rule. Shankar Bhagavan said, well, this is good, you can go. But still, you cannot find honor there. If you go there, it's a big problem. You can go forcefully. I cannot go against you, you can go. Just I am saying it is not good for you if you go. But Sati Bhagavan, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, I don't know, some problem is there, took permission forcefully. Gone there. Then after that, she find no yajna bhag, no yajna, share of yajna there for Shankar Bhagavan. She become very angry. Father not asking any point to him, to her. Then she become very angry, leave her body by Jogaval and burn of his body, her body. And speaking, I am not going to keep my body which I got from you. Then Devi, leave body. Burnt up by Yogagni, sitting in yoga with cloth covered up face, doing yoga and burnt up. Gone. The whole creation they are actually fearing. What happens? Then Shankar Bhagavan got information. I become very angry. You know the afterwards you know everything. Huh? Because there was curse between Nandiya and Bhrigu. This way. Nandiya speaking, you can get goat face this way. It cannot be false. So this way, after that, because actually those ghost and Birbhadra came and cut some face, total face, and throw into fire, so burnt up. When Shankar Bhagavan came to re-establish the, Yajna, was no way, face gone. Then actually, goat fest. This way. But after that, Daksha started praying in front of Shankar. I have done mistake, this, that, with appealing mood. But in Tikaka, those who are making commentary, they're speaking, though Daksha praying in front of Shankar Bhagavan, still there is smell of offense there, still, begging for pardon. Okay, I have done mistake, this, that, all okay. But smell of offense is there, not totally cleared. It is written. It was commentary, it is written, the offense was not totally cleared. Some smell was there. That's why the Daksha leave his body. After this, and Prachitas appeared as Prachita Chakshus Manantar. In Chakshus Manantar, he came in the form of Prachitas Daksha. Then from Prachitas Daksha, then, you know, Prachita. Then after that, you know, Prachitas Daksha. From Daksha onward, you know, one by one. Then after that, you can get, Diti, Aditi, all. This way, now Daksha, from Daksha this way came. So those who are making commentary, they are speaking that this Prachitas, from this Prachitas Daksha, this way we got. This way. So problem is that there's now Shambharaho when came. It is written the Shambharaho came in Chakshus Manantar. First Varaho, I say Sambhu Manantar in Shet Varaho Kalpa. Second Varaho, Krishna Varaho came in, you know, Chakshus Manantar. That time actually he fight with Hiranyaksha. Then the fighting was there. After that, the earth was delivered, and this way, this problem. This way they are discussing actually. Now point is that is Varahadev a big fighting with who? Hiranyaksha. Now Vidurji Maharaj asking question in front of Maitreya, who is this Hiranyaksha? Hiranyakasipu, we are speaking because. You are speaking about Hiranyaksha. Hiranyakasipu. Hiranyakasipu is actually in 7th canto, you can get this detailed discussion about Hiranyakasipu after that. Because Hiranyakasipu wanted to take revenge against Vishnu, because Vishnu killed his brother, younger brother. So, some angry attitude is there. He wanted to take revenge against Vishnu. That topic is totally different. Now, Vidurji Maharaj asking, when they took birth? This way, I told you the situation, how Diti Ma, mother give birth to two twin son, baby. And they become very fearful, become very strong. And fighting with everybody, all demigods there actually, with club is going to heaven, fighting with, like demon, big demon. After that, everybody praying in front of Brahma, what to do. Then after that, Varahadev actually appear. How? This is the point. Actually, there, Hiranyakasipu, the Brahma speaking, they are actually joy vijay. Two personal associates of Bhagavan, Narayan, in Vaikuntha. So, the Vidur asking, how possible Vaikuntha, Jadgatya, non-divartante, tadhyama paramama? If you go to Vaikuntha, no need of falling down to material worlds. Well, you are right. But still, there is some reason. By the desire of Bhagavan, you can come. By the desire of Bhagavan, Supreme Mahav, even Narayan, you can come. Otherwise, no possibility. This way, how they came? Then, Maitreya speaking, actually, they are the gate man there in Vaikuntha, Jai Vijay, two. They are, in gate man, they have four hands, like everything, Sarupya, same. Darshan like Narayan. They are standing there. And the Chatusan, actually, they have their power to go anywhere. Without any, obstruction. They can go anywhere. They can travel. So this way, they are traveling here and there. And from Brahma, someday they heard so nice, I mean, qualities of Supreme Lord, and the view, I mean, nice, I mean, darshan of they got from by speech. So they got this information from Brahma. So naturally they are interested. So gradually, on traveling here and there, they reach Vaikuntha Loka. And in Vaikuntha Loka, they find so nice Vaikuntha Loka there, so beautiful. There they gradually 1, 2, 3, there 1 gate, 2 gate, 3 gate, they are going inside. After that, they wanted to enter and take darshan of Narayan. But 2 gate men, they, why? Where you are going? We cannot allow you. Why? They are naked actually. 5 years boy. They actually, first creation. In the series of creation, they are the first creation actually, among. So, they are Chatusan. Actually, but still, they don't understand who, actually without clothes, everything, they do stop. Actually, there cannot be any Maya. This point should be clarified. Why they are Vaikuntha Parsad? Why they cannot understand? Because there is no Maya. They should understand. Past, present, and future all clear in front of a Vaikuntha Parsad. Why they don't understand? They should understand. Who they are? It is written that by the desire of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Jogmaya acting this way, so they couldn't understand. This way, they stop them entering into the. Then with one stick in hand, then Chatusan become angry. Why? Though I know you four are Vaikuntha Parsad, but still how you develop this kind of attitude? Because in Vaikuntha there is no obstruction, nothing, no Maya, nothing. How you develop this kind of brain? You don't allow us to see, take darshan of Bhagavan? No, we cannot allow you. And become with stick, they become very, I know. Then Chatusang become angry. That angry attitude also, Brahma, they give cards. That actually, Jai Vijay, they giving cards. The you are doing like a demon. Why you are not allowing us? So we curse you, we too, that you are going to take birth in this material world as demon. You have to take birth because your attitude is totally wrong. In Vaikuntha, this kind of attitude is not possible to have. So then they fall down on leg. Well, excuse us, we couldn't understand actually. Then in the meantime, as the Narayan with Lakshmi Devi, Narayan with Lakshmi Devi running and coming in front of gate. And taking darshan of Narayan, they become overwhelmed. They're looking at Narayan. Then after that, they are praying actually. Bhagavan also praying to them. They are Chatusan. They are Rishi. Then Chatusan speaking, we have done wrong. You see, we curse. Bhagavan Narayan speaking, no, actually it is by the desire, by my desire. Otherwise, it is my desire. Because Jai Vijay wanted to fight, give satisfaction to Supreme Lord through fighting. Birras. Hero Ras, they wanted to satisfy Krishna. That's why according to their desire, I was bound to influence them. Inside their heart, he give them and give inspiration. So that this way they stop you. So this way they stop you. And now you curse, that is also according to my desire. So this way, after that, Joy and Vijay, they are falling down, they are crying in front of Narayan. And say, if you are coming in favorable, going to run your life in a very favorable way, then it will take 7 births. Otherwise, within 3 births, you can come back. Then after that, you know actually how Ravan, Kumbhakarna, this way, Shishupal and Dantavarka, this way actually. they came, Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu first they took bath at Hiranyakashipu. Then second, in Treta Yuga different. This way. So they actually took bath and here in the womb of Diti mother. Then actually they are when Krishna Varaha coming, Krishna Varaha wanted to deliver this art from water. It came, it in there. Then in the meantime, that demon searching Vishnu. He cannot understand he is Vishnu. He is saying, how we gave, we find one beast there inside water. Who you are? Then asking, very big fighting, I mean, altercation. After that, a big fighting. Big fighting going on. And after that fighting, you see, fighting going on gradually. Then after that, he is fighting. After that, this Varahadev actually wanted to deliver him, kick him here inside. Then after that fracture, then Adi Dvaitya, Hiranyaksha fall down. Then all demigods, they are praying very nicely. We are saved actually. Actually, this demon putting so much trouble in front of us. So now we are saved. This way, actually, demigods, they are praying in front of Varahadev. So Varahadev, after delivering, the Varahadev disappear. Varahadev, earth place in proper place. After that, this is Krishna Varaha. This Krishna Varaha. Actually, when Satugna, you can find these two deities, Shet Varaha and Krishna Varaha. They are in Mathura. Actually, that deity was there in Lanka, Sri Lanka. Then after Satugna went there, from there Satugna took this after Ravana took this deity, and that deity was installed there in Mathura. In Mathura it was installed. And that's why we can take darshan of Mathura was immediately. This way, this is the history of Varahadev. So, if you have any question about Varahadev, you can put question. You have any question about Varahadev appearance, disappearance? One in the, you can, when Krishna Varaha disappear, this place you can find there in Shoro, one place is there. From Mathura, actually 80 kilometers, I think. 70, 80 kilometers, 60. Shoro, one place. Kasganj. There you can get Shoro. There Adi Varaha when disappear, there one lake is there. One lake, big lake. There. That lake is usually disappear, Brahma, I mean, Krishna Varaha. That's why you can find this lake. Everybody going there, Ganga and all rivers, I mean pure rivers, they are there, water. You can offer funeral cake there. This is a very pure place actually. I've been there many times. Very Tulsidasji actually took birth there. Is it there? So if you have any question about Varahadev, no?
Some deities of Varahadev in Mathura.
In Koladvip,
Navadvip. Devananda Gaudiamat and in Keshav Chi Gaudiamat.
Devananda Gaudiamat actually, Param Pujibhat Keshav Kusi Maharaj installed the deity, specially. Specially, Keshav Kusi Maharaj installed the deity. So, any deity you find there? No? Any other deity?
Yes, in Keshav Chi Gaudiamat also.
Kesavji Gauri Mahat, actually it was installed later.
Yes.
So Kesav Gosi Maharaj, with very nice view, he has installed, Varahadev there, and he put the name Devananda Gauri Mahat. That also some reason behind it. Because Devanando committed offense at the lotus feet of Sivas. So to give you a clear, remembrance, always try to remember this point. Never try to commit apradh. Devananda Guru Mahārāj was this name, Keshava Goswami Mahārāj giving this name. Why? Because everybody can remember this point. Nobody can do commit apradh. This why. So, any other deity you find there? No?
No, my question was that I know that the devotees generally go before they start their parikram,
what?
Yeah. How
often?
Yeah, could you speak something about that?
Yes. Actually, Kolodvis is a place very special. It is going to another topics actually. Kolodvis is very, any offense you have, Kolodvis is a nice place. That's why Parampuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj making mat there. Is a special place where all offense can be excused. Because Bhagavan, I mean Gauranga Mahaprabhu to Devananda Pandit, Gopal Chapal, here actually, this place, a special place. It's called Aparad Banjan Pat. There, any kind of, actually offense we are doing all the time, of different kind of offense. Different kinds of offense always going on. Sometime we are doing Dham Aparad, sometime doing Nam Aparad, sometime doing Aparad to Mahaprasadam. Name, Nama Prad, Dhamma Prad, always going. To get offense, you see, you must be very sincere. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you are not at all sincere about how to stop committing aparad. That is main problem, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. So actually, when you are doing aparad, actually, if you recite Bindadivistakam, daily, specially on Dadasi night time. If you recite Bindadivistakam daily, then your normal aparad can be excused. Daily, actually daily aparad going on. Some or other kind of aparad you are committing, that can be excused. Bhagavan, or two chapter of Gita you will have to recite daily with feeling. Not mechanically. With feeling you will have to recite two chapters of Gita, or you will have to recite Bindastakam, Gangyo, Champiyo, Tarutabindi, you will have to recite daily, and specially on Dadasi Tithi night time. It is a commitment by Bhagavan, I can excuse. This way you can avoid this. Even kind of opera, because opera is going on all the time. You cannot. Now another question coming, that Chotusvan, there actually, they are doing bhajan for Om. Om iti ekaksharam, baharanamam anusmaran, ja prati tejanam deham, sa jati paramam gatim, in Gita. Om, this word. Om is Parabrahma. Om is equal to Parabrahma in the form of sound. Om is equal to Mahamantra. No doubt. So you can find actually whole creation came from this Om. O, U, Mo. Three level pronunciation. Actually, from Om, this sound, actually, whole creation came. Now, question is that the Chotusvan, they are worshipping Om, this Akshar. How they got darshan of Narayan? This is the main question. Actually, they heard something about, they are actually worshipping Ekakshar Brahma, Nirvishya. They are doing. But somehow, they have had the chance to hear from Brahma. After that, they having some desire to take darshan of Narayana. Aksharajusham opi Actually, they are worshipping this Om, this Akshar. But somehow, they got this inspiration from Brahma. So, this way, you see, gradually, the Srila going on. After that, they took darshan of Narayan. Rama Vaikuntha, actually. Rama Vaikuntha. There. Some different kind of judgment there. Actually, different kind of judgment there. So, this way, they got darshan, actually. Tasyarabindo nayanasya padarabindo kinjalko misro kinjalko tulsidala misro makaranda vayu. This way, actually, some offerings into the lotus feet of Krishna, I mean Narayan, some tulsidal and flower and chandan, this smell came into the nose of Chatusan. Tasyarabinda nanasya padarabinda kinjalka misya makaranda kinjalka tulsidala misya makaranda vayu. And actually sabibare no. And you're going inside with smell, as a smell. Then, chakaratisham sangshobam aksharajusham upichittatonu. They're getting some reaction. When the smell going inside, then gradually they got some sort of reaction. This way, after that they are not worshipping Ekakshar Mantra because they got darshan of Narayan. So, now, this way. So, any question more?
Which rasa is for Ahadev?
Vibhatsa rasa.
Vibhatsa.
Jukupsa. Any question? No? Then over. Today, I stop. Panchakalpadurvashike pasindhubhavajupatitanam pavanabhavishnabhyo namon. Actually, we can keep our katha around 6 o'clock is good. Because otherwise I cannot change my anik on time. He cannot do arati. All problem big. So, 6 o'clock is good. No, it's a problem for me. I cannot complete my anik. It's my usual rule.
As you like, Maharaj.
We cannot make actually big problem.
Maharaj, one question.
Uh-huh.
Yesterday was also Ramanujacharya disappearance and Madhavacharya.
Madhavacharya, actually, it will take long time.
So
Ramanujacharya, Madhavacharya, one topic is going to take long time.
Only just to understand this, maybe you can tell something about this Vastu Parinamvat and Shakti
Parinamvat. Actually, it's a different talking, actually. Still, you are putting question, have some time we can discuss. Actually, Ramanujacharya took birth to destroy all Mayavad. And Madhavacharya also, he wanted to destroy all Mayavad. Big way. Ramanujacharya actually, Ram Anuja Acharya. He came from Lakshmanji, big powerful. This way, Ramanujacharya actually has very nice, actually, 4 out of 4 Acharyas, Ramanujacharya is one of them. Nimbarkacharya, Vishnu Swami, Ramanujacharya and Madhavacharya, 4 Sampradaya. These 4 Sampradaya, they are dealing with these 4 topics actually. Actually, Bhagavan, Jeev, Shakti, Maya, they are all. But their actually discussion is little difference from one each other is different. That's why actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when appearing, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to balance the Siddhanta of 4 Acharya, giving nice Siddhanta about Achinta Vedavet Tatya. That's why Ramanujacharya also believing Shakti is different. Shakti Tattva, Ramanujacharya believing. and Jiva Tattva also, and Bhagavan Supreme Lord. Four, all those four acharyas, they are dealing with same thing. But it is a little different, actually. Ramanujacharya believe in this tattva, actually Supreme Lord is also always a separate identity. And Jiva, now have it. Jiva also separate. And Maya actually grabs him, those Jiva, because they are actually marginal potency. So anytime there is possibility, they can get covered up with Maya. This way they can develop different kind of desire. This problem. And actually, Ramanujacharya is a big acharya actually. He makes so many disciples. Bharadacharya, you know, one of his disciples. So many. Actually, Bharadacharya, one Grihastha devotee. He went to his house. That time Bharadacharya was not there. His wife was there. Very pity. Very nice. Then when they are very poor actually, very very poor. When Gurudev, Ramanujacharya went there, there was nobody, and there was no cloth. Their wife, very very bhakti, big bhakti. She cannot come outside. He is giving sound, Gurudev. I cannot come out. So Gurudev could understand this her position. Waiting for some time, because she is giving this only cloth for drying up in sunlight. After that, she came out and gives seva. Yeah, there's a big problem. Nice. The now point is that there's no money, nothing. How she can do seva? Because husband is not there. After that, she went to a big businessman. Who is dealing with rice, wheat, ghee, and requesting him if you can give this amount of wheat, rice, everything what I need, my Gurudev coming, so I like to do seva of my Gurudev, and finally I can pay you. How to pay? You have no money, so you'll have to come with me lonely. She could understand the modi. She said, well, still I am ready. I like to do Guru Seva. She coming and doing all Guru Seva with all item she got. After that, Ramanujacharya giving some food remains, prasadam, uchishta. Ramanujacharya antajami, give uchishta, some prasadam. She took some prasadam care there because she commit. Then after that businessman, is very happy. She is coming. Now she can. He can. Then after that, wife of Bharadacharya she is speaking. First you take prasadam. After that I can do whatever you like. No problem. I can pay you accordingly. Then she give prasadam to him. He going inside, taking prasadam. Instantly after taking prasadam, changing his mood. Totally, mood change. And coming in front of wife of Bharadacharya, falling in lay, excuse me, you are my mother. This is a magic spell. So many stories there. Time is limited. I can discuss specially about Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, specially one time.
When Shankaracharya came, he said that this Brahma will be transformed into this material.
Yes, I discussed this many times. I told you also, according in my Harikatha, the Shankaracharya wanted to establish this point that Brahma is become distorted, bikar prapta hai, Brahma bikari. This point, Ramanujacharya said, no, yeah. Brahma need not get disturbed. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu finally told in front of Kashi Mayavadi, why? Brahma is can get disturbed. Distorted. Need not, because one touchstone in this material world can change. Then whereas Brahma only is not, actually Shakti, Shakti or Brahma. Brahma and Shakti non-different. So Shakti or Brahma can distort, can distort it and get, and can manifest in form of material world. This material world. Shakti Parinati. Shankaraja speaking, Brahma become distorted and take the form of this material world. And they, actually Shankaracharya don't try to believe that Bhagavan is Nitya, Bhagavan Sarup, they don't believe. Shankaracharya don't believe that Bhagavan Nitya Sarup. Shankaracharya don't believe. Actually this material world, actually Shankaracharya, as per Shankaracharya, Shankaracharya speaking, this material was actually nothing. Just like a shadow of a snake. Actually, there is one rope, somebody looking that, oh, there is snake. That's why they are fearing. They become fear. Mayavadi, they are giving this example. There is one rope at night time, so shadow is there, so somebody become fear why there is snake. Now, Vaishnava, they are actually speaking this thing. Well, maybe there is one rope, but conception of snake is there. Conception of snake is not wrong. Snake is there somewhere. Snake is not wrong. Due to snake, because everybody know the dangerous. That's why they, maybe here it is rope, but snake is there somewhere. Due to the conception of snake, it is in reality they feel. So actually, and now shadow is there, but actually somewhere snake is there. So this material world is not useless. This material was is not at all false. Bhagavan is Nitya, Jiv Nitya. Bhagavan is Nitya, Jiv Nitya. Maya is also Nitya. Maya, I mean both Maya. Yogamaya, Mahamaya. Mahamaya is also Nitya. It's Shakti. Shakti cannot be false. So Mahamaya actually shadow of Yogamaya anyway. But still, Jagat, this material world is there. And maybe this material was not permanent. Someday, it can collapse, I mean, Srishti. But still, Srishti is there. Srishti, you cannot say that creation is false. Shankaracharya speaking, this creation is totally false. Like in dream you are seeing everything in, when you wake up, you can see, all false, useless. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Ramanujaya speaking, no, it cannot be so. Creation is not permanent, but still creation is not false. Creation is there. Creation is there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also established this point. Creation is there. Maybe you can say it is not permanent, so you can feel this point, but creation is not false. But Shankaracharya always fighting. As creation is all useless, this, that. This way. So, actually, when Madhvacharya came, Madhvacharya, he also more forcefully. Ramanujacharya actually, Parabhakho Giribarjo, one book written by Ramanujacharya. Parabhakho Giribarjo, Bajro. What is mean? For the opponent party, Ramanujacharya make one thunderbolt, Bajra, can throw and crush them. It's meaning. Parabhakho Giribarjo. Writing one big, 6 volumes of books. There he breaking all the arguments by Mayavadi. Mayavadi. Mayavadi arguments break everything. You cannot stand actually. After that, when Madhvacharya came, Madhvacharya more forcefully break actually. This way. So actually Shankaracharya when wrote Mayavadi Siddhanta, then Madhvacharya wanted to check up that total theory of Mayavad so that he can write. But they keep this book very secretly. They don't allow anybody to check up. With one disciple, Madhvacharya went there in Sarada Mat, there in Himalaya. Somehow in guise, steal that book. But after that, when they coming, going away, in the middle they could catch him. Big fighting going on, they take away books. But in the meantime, the disciple of Madhvacharya recite whole, Kuresh, recite all whole books. Gurudev speaking, then we wanted to check up this so that we can give fitting answer. Then our book is again stolen. Kuresh speaking, okay, no problem Gurudev, I can recite everything in front of you. Whole book, by the mercy of Gurudev. This way, whole book came. Madhvacharya. Then they give more fitting answer actually. So this way actually, Ramanujacharya went to their one Mayavadi, Jadavacharya there to get lesson in childhood. A nice history. But Jadavacharya is Madhivedanta teaching. But after that, actually, he started reading in front of Gurudev, Mayavadi. But he cannot accept the argument by Gurudev. All teaching Mayavadi. Someday he is giving message of Gurudev, body message with oil. And when Gurudev speaking some wrong Siddhanta, Kapyasana, that Gurudev comparing the eyes, lotus eyes of Bhagavan Narayan with the backside of monkey. Then Ramanujacharya in boy very, very sad, started crying. And the drop of that hot water falling on backside of Gurudev. Gurudev, what? You are crying? Why? Gurudev, excuse me, you explain this point this way. Why? What point you can explain yourself? Then he is explaining this way. Kong pivoti, this way. Surya sun, when rise, means kong pivoti, means kong, means surya, when rises, it takes water from lake and everywhere. Because hot sunrise, sunrise is very, then after that, due to scorchy sunlight, then water vaporizes and goes. This way he discuss, then Jadavacharya, well, if he is going to live, then he can destroy all my Siddhanta. I must kill this boy. He wanted to make a nice plot so that he can kill Ramanujacharya, but he couldn't kill because Bhagavan is going to save him. This way, Ramanujacharya was totally saved. This way, very nice. He compared with, sunlight when rises, that same color. He compared with it. That is a dirty explanation given by Gurudev. It's not good. This way. So somehow they wanted to go to north, Himalaya, someplace. But in between, Gurudev giving instruction to those other students so that they can kill Ramanujacharya in the midway in jungle and throw him out. Because if this boy is going to live, then he is going to destroy all Mayavad Siddhanta. But Bhagavan going to save Ramanujacharya, nobody can kill. So many history actually. So any other question you have? Then I like to stop.
Yes, why Maharaj, if Madhvacharya wrote a commentary on the Vedanta Sutra.
Madhvacharya?
Yeah.
Huh.
Is it not true? Then why were our Vaishnavas, Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya was attacked or accused of not having a
Actually, I already told you 10 years back, almost 10 years back, I by the grace of Gurudev, I wrote one book to stop their fighting. Madhvacharya Amnay ki Guru Parampara Nai, this book is Bengali. If in future I can translate into English, I can try, because time is very limited. So many seva, I cannot make up. All the time I am doing Sanskrit article, almost 100 articles. I cannot find any man who can type. Then I find one man in Vrindavan who can type. He respect me very much. That this way I am doing. Because computer man need so many math, need to establish math, disciple, this way I can get. So gradually I am doing actually. So this way they cannot fight. I can give this argument actually. To stop their fighting, I give argument. Madhvacharya Amnay, it is a long discussion I need. How Baladev Vidyabhushan came in line with Gauriya Vaishnava, how we get link with Madhvacharya, this way, it's a long history, long discussion. Someday I can discuss on this topic only. We have link. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Prabhupada speaking, 100% we have link. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, some point is there in Chaitanya Chaitamito. On this point, some Vaishnava, they are actually Mayavadi. They are in guise of Vaishnava. They also double fighting, double way, triple way. That we are not.
They say reject
them. They are Vaishnava, externally. But they don't believe Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. They like to establish the Siddhanta Sundarananda Vidyavino. They like to break. Actually, we have connection.
I was thinking, because we are called Brahma
Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya.
So my question is, why was this need that Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu had to again write a commentary? Because a commentary was already there, but they were accusing.
Actually, you are right. You are right. Actually, we have connection with Madhvacharya because they worship Bal Gopal also. One positive point, they Vigraha Seva, Madhvacharya established Vigraha Seva very strongly. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu got this point from them, very positive point. And actually, point is that Madhvacharya was bound to give commentary on the basis of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya philosophy, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's darshan. Because though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Lord, still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally not writing anything. Sampradaya pravartan, to start one sampradaya anything, it is not the duty of Supreme Lord. It is the duty of a high class devotee. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pointing out this Achinta Bhedava Tattva, but still somebody fighting. So ultimately, when in Galta, one place is there in Jaipur, there are big fighting going among Gaudiya devotees and all other sampradayas. They want to put them aside. They say, you have no right to worship, because we have right to worship Govinda Dev through the channel of Rupa Goswami Pad. We are Gaudiya. But they don't believe that you have no right, because how you can worship? You have no commentary. Gaudiya Sampradaya is a new Sampradaya. They are speaking this way. They are fighting. Then Baladev Vidyabhushan told, I need only 7 days only. Within 7 days, I can represent that we have Siddhanta, Vedanta, Vasya. Because at that time, if Gita Vasya, Upanishad Vasya is not there, Vedanta Vasya not there, three. If any sampradaya not having three commentary, they are not treated as your authentic sampradaya. Upanishad, Gita and Vedanta, three Vasya. All sampradaya, four sampradaya they have, but Gauriya sampradaya don't have. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already told, Jet Bhagavat is the total commentary of Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Pema Apamartho Mahano Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matam Idam Tattadharana Parah. Arthoyam Brahma Sutyanam. Arthoyam Brahma Sutyanam. It is written. and Garuda Purana. This Bhagavatam is the total commentary of Vedanta, or Tvayam Brahma Sutyanam. Is it? So this way, big fighting going on. Then after that, he took permission from them. I can represent Vedanta commentary. Then he came in front of Govinda ji and started fasting without water, without prasadam, crying day and night. What to do? Govinda, you are Chaitanya. You are Gauranga Mahaprabhu. You are Krishna. But we are insulted this way. So what is the way out? Then Govinda came in rain. No problem. You take pen and, you know, paper. I mean, leaf. That time no paper. I'm going on. Then Govinda going, speaking, and Bhavata Vidyavasam writing. This way, Govinda Vasya. That's why his name is Govinda Vasya. And it is written there that Gopinath Acharya was in Chaitanya Leela, was there in front of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was giving full commentary on actual Vedanta Vasya in front of Sarvabhauma. Sarvabhauma giving Mayavadi Vasya, Mahaprabhu breaking in front of him. That time it is written that Gopinath Acharya was silently sitting in front of them. That Gopinath Acharya leaving his body, I mean, is also transcendental body, Chaitanya Parsat, came in the form of Baladev Vidyavasan. It is written. He heard everything in Gaur Leela. That Siddhanta by the mercy of Govinda started writing. Govinda speaking, everything written. And that commentary, represented in front of all four sampradayas, then they are just shut up. They cannot speak anything. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not speaking any new thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving balance, some balance, reconcile. Achinta Vedavetatya. Dvaitadvaita, Shuddhadvaita, Mayavadi Siddhanta, Shuddhadvaita. This way, there is some difference there. By Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving Achinta Bhedavatatya, Siddhanta, through which four different kind of judgment this is giving some balance by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way, we have 100% link with Madhvacharya. Somebody is speaking that Baladev Gurudasam breaking that link, but it is not there. When giving Upanishad Bhashya, Vedanta Bhashya, Baladev Vidyavasan giving link with Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya. And in Parikrama book also you can find documents by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Madhvacharya when came here, Shankaracharya also came. Mahaprabhu said, well, you can go out. Your Siddhanta cannot, you cannot, it's pure dham. Madhvacharya also came. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, bless him, I am going to take your sampradaya in future. Very good. Madhvacharya came here. Long ago, not now. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this dham is nitya. Not that when Madhvacharya came, long ago. Then what is the question of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance? No question. But still, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared. In front of Chatushan also, in Belpukur. In front of Saptasi. And you see, Varanasi, there, here, Harihar Khetra, just opposite side, that deep is, I forget, what is that deep? I forget. That deep, there. Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami Maharaj wanted to make one mount there.
Ramanujacharya, he had a dream also in Jagannath, I think, from that he should go to...
In Jagannath, where?
I don't know, I don't remember this fully.
Actually, Ramanujacharya first went there, actually, in Puri also. Mm-hmm. Here, different case. Ramanujacharya came, and Madhvacharya also came, Vishnu Swami also came. They all got darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But especially for Madhvacharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blessing, I am going to take your sampradaya. going to get a link from your sampradaya. Ramanujacharya went to Puri to re-establish that puja and everything, because they are Brahmin predominated. They wanted to establish rules and regulation very properly. But in Jagannath Puri, they postponed. They are doing seva out of love. Then one night, Jagannath throwing him outside of dham, sleeping condition, all going to long away, hundreds of kilometers away. You stay with your rules and regulation. Here, my different kind of seva. This way, Ramanujacharya was sent outside Puri. He wanted to re-establish seva. Actually, so you do believe 100%, we have link with Madhvacharya. Though one or two point is there, some Vaishnava, they are actually demon, they are fighting with. In our sampradaya, they are making, different siddhanta. They don't believe Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They are saying, Mahaprabhu told there when went to Urupi, Tomar sampradaya. Tomar sampradaya, in your sampradaya, this fault. So how possible? This way they are fighting. Actually, I would say this way, you are Vaishnava, doing tilak and everything. At the time of Prabhupada, those Vaishnava, they have more and more realization, everything, that time. Now also, if you can do bhajan, you can get. But actually, point is that, if some Vaishnava become sahajya, how you can understand? Suppose you meet with some Vaishnava who is not at all in line with Prabhupada, but you cannot detect. He is giving commentary, he is saying that I am linked with Prabhupada. Actually, they are sahajya. So this way you cannot detect, everybody can do. Somebody going to Prabhupada, they leave Prabhupada forever, but still they now say, we are linked with Prabhupada. You can go to Rana Ghat here, there. All Vaishnava going there to take prasadam. I am laughing. They say, I have link with Prabhupada. I mean, our Gurudev, my Gurudev and me speaking. They. Actually, they have no link with Prabhupada. They cut. They do opera and 12 gospels. This way, in commentary, Bhaman Goswami speaking this way, Kesava Goswami speaking this way, then actually, in Madhva Parampara, actually, they worship Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Actually, from Madhusudan Pad, one devotee, Prabhupada got, Saraswati Thakur, got one letter, that in Urupi, all those bench of Acharya, 10 or 12 Acharya, I forget actually, they are dancing like Gopi in front of Gopal. In his letter, Prabhupada, in his letter, speaking, they are dancing, Gopi Bhav. Now maybe after that Acharya change, maybe he is not in line with Madhvacharya, he breaking his rule. Many times it happens so. Parampara link this way, we are breaking. That's why Baladev Vidya was repeatedly speaking this point. Amnai Parampara should be pure. Baladev Vidya was speaking this point repeatedly. We should think about Shuddha Parampara. There should not be any breakage of line. Sometime, line going on, in between from Prabhupada some breakage there. You cannot get any link. That's why Prabhupada giving 50% Guru Parampara, 50% Madhva Parampara, Bhagavat Parampara. Being Guru Parampara, if you think this way, maybe from this Guru, he got the, from Guru, this Guru. But after that, they break rules. Some Guru is there who is not following his Gurudev. But you are taking Diksha. But actually you are losing contact. So Prabhupada saying this point, scientific point. Actually, Bhagavad Parampara is most scientific. I can show this point, actually, very scientific point. So, Madhvacharya, Bhaman Goswami speaking, Kesava Goswami also speaking this way, that maybe that time, who is there in chair, maybe is some problem, is leaking, kind of breaking link with Gurudev, previous Gurudev. This why they develop this kind of problem. They explaining mukti, this, that.
Yes.
Actually, Madhvacharya never wanted to speak that way. Though some point is there, actually Madhvacharya giving commentary on Bhagavatam, you can find that he is on about Gopikas. He is not accepting this point. I mean, you can find, maybe by the instruction of Bhagavan, he got instruction to extend his philosophy up to this point, because some other acharya is there. So anyway, Madhvacharya is Prabhupada speaking, there's Gopi Bab is there, everything. Maybe that time when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reaching there, they break this.
They say these eight sannyasis,
they are
worshipping in that Gopi, but they don't tell it outside. They
themselves. They don't dance him night side.
Let to go it out, this Siddhanta.
How this problem created, I don't know. Maybe to save themselves from Mayavadi, or don't know how to possible. Because those South Indian place, you see, they are Mayavadi, some Ramanujacharya Sampradaya, some Madhvacharya, big actually Sampradaya there. This way. So any question more? We have link 100%. Don't we? I already proved it through books. If I can translate it, it's good. Nobody can read Bengali. How we can translate? Rai Ramananda Sangbad, one nice book. It also should be translated into English. Very nice. Within small book, you can get total guidance from top to bottom. Like mirror, you can see everything. So I like to do, but it will take time. How long I can live, that I also don't know. Let me see. Vancha kalpataru asti ke pasinda bhavishpati danang pavana bhavishna bhyona.
Jesham sa esha bhagavan dayedananta sarvatmanasrita padam yudinirvalikam te dustaramati taranti cha devamayam No mamahumiti dhi sasigal bhakshi tasya ravindanayana sapada ravindu kinjal kamisat tulasidal makarandu vayu antaragataha sabivarena tesam chakyara sankshovam aksharaju samopi chittatona